they told Manboy about it. They made a decision what they're going to do. And so they're going to try to go out. So they don't know that they're being set up because, you know, Franklin went in and he was like, hey, man, I got these guns for you, man. I got the gun supply for you. I'm going to supply you with the guns. You're going to go ahead and take out Manboy. And then basically told Manboy kind of some of the similar thing. I got a problem that you can't handle. I can help you out with this. So you're going to try to meet him up and then get a straight ambush. How did you think that plan was going to work out, you know, watching it unfold on TV?
I knew it wasn't going to work. Because it just, man, I knew it wasn't going to work. And especially when Scully drove into the warehouse, like the setup was wrong. You drove into the warehouse and most of the time when, you know, you watching the show, but they always meet somebody in the open area, right? There's no hiding spots.
Mm-hmm.
There's no hiding spots, right? But they tried to pull Scully into a warehouse with trailers everywhere. You know, it was just, it didn't look right. So of course, when Scooter Scully came in, he was like, hold on, stop the car. You know what I mean? Because it's too much going. It was too much, too many places, too many blind spots. So I'm like, bro, this is not going to work. I'd have stopped too. As soon as I, man, it's not going to work. So, man. And then like you said, I feel it wasn't going to work anyway because Franklin, bro, he was panicking. Franklin was panicking. He tried to come up with anything, any way, like, oh, this is what we gonna do. Nah, man. So he didn't come up with a good plan. That was a terrible plan, man.
It definitely was, man. He didn't quite, like I said, he's been off his feet for a while and things kind of spun out of control, got out of hand. You know, his auntie and his uncle couldn't really handle it because Jerome, he really not that street guy. He not like that. You know, he tough, he big, he tough, but he not really like that street guy. Peach is more the guy who can get down in the streets and make things happen.
Yeah.
That when you saw that, how they had that whole, like I said, that whole setup, it just felt weird. You're in a hangar bay and you have all these cargoes in there and it's all kind of stacked up with doors and things like that. And then you see Scully coming there. He all geeked up on this drug. I don't even know what drug he got. He put it in his ear. He drops a cup and this dude driving like, man, you finna do that right now? What are you doing? He's like, man, this gonna help me focus. And all the time it did help him focus because when he was ultrally, you know, he was hyper focused. So when he got to the door, he got into the first, he was like, hey, stop, what's going on? Something on right. And he started seeing roaches and he was in his mind, he was like, look, something.
That boy got paranoid, boy. That's what he
mad paranoid. And Franklin, he way off in addition, like, hey, calm down. What's on? What's going on?
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden you see man boy, one of his boys, just kind of like, you know, he trigger happy. Even though
nervous.
Even Peaches told him before, man, just calm down. Just be patient. Let him get all the way in first. Like, man, yeah, we're going to do it. Let him get all the way in. And then all of a sudden, he jumps out with the Uzi, and things just go left mad fast. And first thing Franklin do, hit the ground. He got the crutch on. You see why he was there, because he not physically ready to be in the middle of something. Especially no gunfight.
Yeah, he should have never been there. I mean, he had to be there, right, because he set it up. He told him, I'm going to introduce you to the guy with the guns. So he got to be there, but he should have sent Peaches and all them. Peaches and his partner, Vietnam vet, man. Hey, go handle him, man. Go handle it. Take him out. Use your tactical skills. Take him out.
That's when you got to be a boss and let your general, you know, saying, do things. You got to trust them to go out there and get stuff done.
Yep.
Gotta let the hitters be hitters. You know, you're in a position where you're not healthy enough to duck and dodge a gunfight. You know what I'm saying? So your job is to like tell the general what to do. He go out and execute the plan, and he come back and let you know what happened. For you to be in the middle of it, and you know it's
about the boss. There's no reason the boss supposed to be there.
You don't supposed to be there, bro. You're probably like, hey, man, I got the guy already set up for you. They're going to be there. And then it go down. You do the setup. But you on a cane. You can't run. You on no vest on. You can't do nothing. And this man got a rifle. He can hit you from a distance. But just the whole, like I said, the whole setup and the whole vibe of it just was all weird. And then for me to see Jerome get that body, drop that body, and just to see in his eyes, it let me know right then at that moment, like, he ain't about that life.
Mm-mm. Bro, ain't nothing about that life. Franklin ain't about that life. Like you said, Jerome ain't about that life. Louis, I'm like, none of them, man. I mean, Franklin should have thought better than that. Like, he got too much to lose. He got to think about his mom and dad, his uncle and auntie, the whole business. Leon. Come on, man. Like,
I think that's where, and I think that's where the whole not being, you know what I'm saying, not being in a position to get Leon back on the squad, because Leon and his crew is the one who is the real muscle of the business. And when you don't have the muscle of the business, you got some other people who not really real muscle. They just bodies, you know what I'm saying? Like Jerome, just a body. He not really a real street guy. He ain't really going out there and dropping bodies and things like Leon. Leon in the trenches. Yeah, in the trenches. He going to war, especially when Franklin was down. He out in the streets. He out there keeping territory safe. You know what I'm saying? He's always been about that life. And for him not to have his number one hitter on his side, I think that's going to cost him, you know, unless he goes out and figure out how to make that relationship better. Because I don't think he was, you know, in a way, Leon felt like he wasn't treating him right. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. I came up with you. We did this together, you know what I'm saying? And then when Franklin kind of almost puts him in his place from time to time, like, man, you messing with the business, man. You know what I'm saying? You letting personal stuff mess with the business. And I think that kind of really just gets to him at times. And so he want to be his own boss, especially with him running the projects and stuff like that.
Right, right. Yeah, Leon. Because, yeah, Leon, he knows that, you know, Franklin is a brain. He's the brains behind the whole thing. And like you said, Leon is the muscle. And I feel like when Franklin went at Leon over that man boy issue, that kind of turned Leon like, you know what? I ain't messing with the dude no more. He picking the money, the business over me. Like, we was together, we didn't have nothing. You know what I mean? And this dude, you know what I mean, got the girl that I once loved, you know what I mean, doing dude in the kitchen while they eating cereals, whatever, he walk in. Hey, Leon didn't like that. And man, I think he was expecting Franklin to have his back on that. And Franklin didn't. Franklin just picked the business and pretty much, man, check Leon like he wasn't nobody, like he was a punk. Yeah. And keep threatening with it. I take the plug. I'ma take it from you. I'ma take, like, holding that over his head, like. Like, hold on, man. We was in the kitchen cooking this together.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly. And so I think that's going to be, that's one of the big things where I think Leon sometimes doesn't think big picture, whereas I think Franklin is always thinking big picture, and sometimes he lose focus on the smaller things, the details and relationships. And he had to realize that relationship is what keeps you safe in the business. You got this guy, he's your muscle. He got the other muscle on the team, and you're the brain. So you got to figure out a way to make that work. And when you are, you know, you're bickering, you're fighting with the muscle, and that messes with the whole business, because you can't think freely. Now you're out here making, you know, rash decisions with your family when they're not really bosses themselves. You know, they're not generals. They're not really out in the streets. You got to have generals, and you got to have, you know, saying bosses. And there's a difference. You got to have people who can think bigger. And Leon's not the big thinker. You know, you have to think about it. Leon doesn't think big. He thinks about right now. He's emotional at times, but he knows how the street works.
And right.
Because Franklin doesn't know how it works. And then when we see, you know, we see Franklin kind of like, you know, being stubborn. They're both being stubborn at the same time. Like, they both don't want to give a little bit for themselves to make the business work in a whole, because Leon's like, man, see, if you think about Leon's mindset, he's like, man, I got the trap. He's like, I got the projects on lock. I got my couple of corners on lock. But he's just thinking small. Whereas, you know what I'm saying, Franklin's thinking like, man, we could take over the entire country.
Right.
Just got to stay with it. We just got to stabilize where we are, and we could think bigger. But Leon's like, man, I got my projects. I got my women. I got my bitches. You know, he got type of stuff. So that's why I think that aspect is going to be tough for them to kind of navigate through. And I'm hopefully they can work this out. I know you talked about this earlier. We talked about them going to that party, or just the whole situation where after the hit go wrong, how shook everybody was when they got back to the club. Moment.
Huh? Oh, man. I'm like, man, it's over. I mean, my thing was, you got to go take Scully out now. You got to, like Peachy was saying, you got to go on the offense. You can't sit back and let them try to, you know, regroup.
Yeah, regroup.
And then, because once he regroup, it's on. He gonna go after your mama, your dad, everybody. Like, they were supposed to go right back. Like, you know what? You know, we can't sit around and see if we got him or not. We got to go check right now. You know what I mean? And so, yeah, I think he messed that up. He messed that up. He should have he should have let Peaches, or I mean Peaches that got shot, right? So yeah. they should have round up whoever they could have round up and go and went and finished him off.
Yeah, and I think that's where he just don't have that street mentality, or he's just panicking and moving too fast and not thinking the step. He's not thinking two steps ahead. He's just like, all right, man, I got to do this, do that, and then we're going to take him out. And then you don't think about, okay, what if it doesn't work? You know what I mean? He wasn't thinking about that. Normally Franklin kind of takes steps back when everybody else is kind of, you know, in the all this noise going on. He used to be able to take a step back and think his way through. But at this time, he really didn't think it through. He didn't think the plan. Nah. He got that cockamamie idea from when Reed kind of gave him the story about the attempted coup or whatever, and he just like, all right, man, we're gonna take both of them out and have them like, dude, what do you mean you're gonna take out Man Boy and you're gonna take out Scully, but then you don't know who's gonna replace them? Like, you're not thinking about this. Like, how you know that their organization gonna be able to stand and withhold without those guys in place, and you don't have anybody to replace them with? Like, he totally didn't listen to that story and take in all the information from the story that Reed gave him. He just like, all right, we're gonna just take them out, and then we're gonna go on from there. Like, the business gonna continue to flow just because these two are. Nah, it's gonna be even more bloodshed than that.
Yeah, it's gonna be even. But the thing I'll be tripping with Franklin about, he too accessible, man. He too accessible to Man Boy and like, why is he always meeting them in their territory? Like, he'd go to the funeral home, or he'd go to Man Boy's hangout, whatever clubhouse or whatever that is. He's too accessible. First of all, they would have to be coming to me. If I was Franklin, you got to come to me. You always got to come to me in my, you know, like when he, remember in the beginning when he used to go cop from Avi. Avi didn't never go down to South Central or wherever he was at. Nope. He had to go up there and see him with all his people there, and he was comfortable. Franklin, he not doing that for some reason. He always is want him and Peaches or something to go see. Like, nah, man, why would you put yourself in harm's way like that?
And it's crazy. I think because he's still learning the game, and then two, he doesn't have that muscle like that. You know what I'm saying? He don't move like that. You know what I'm saying? I've been in the game for so long, so he know how them streets here. Them streets will eat you up if you ain't protected. And he just feel like, you know, so he still feel like he can move around because he the king. He the king of the city right now. But now you can't move like that, bro. You can't be moving
like that.
You can't move like that. Like I said, he's too accessible. People can just hit him on a beeper or show up to the spot or wherever they want. Yeah. He's showing up to meetings and stuff. You know what I'm saying? He going over to Scully house in the middle of the project, in the middle of his project. They all, even the police scared to go in there. Like, you don't go in a jungle like that. Like, why would you do that? So I agree with you on that situation, man. And then for him to try to go get his parents after the fact, after the hit go wrong, to get them to go move, whereas you should have had that line set up first. Like, hey, look, there's some stuff we about to go, it's something about to go down. I need you guys to go, you know what I'm saying? We're going to put you up somewhere to be protected. Because anytime